There were a couple of things that we talked about. The biggest thing, if there's one that I'd like to get out there, is our physicality has to start happening yesterday. We know we're a good team. How do we become a great team? And, first and foremost, we have to understand that the enemy of the great is the good. So we can't get complacent. We got to be all in, and we got to continue building on our narrative that we laid the foundation for last year, continued with this summer with our connectivity and our work ethic, and now going forward, we got to build on it.
Where's the curiosity for you when you look at this roster and you're in the training camp?
How we handle the expectations out there. I try to tell our guys that the expectations, especially from our fans, are high, which they should be because we showed we were a good team last year. Even around the NBA world, the expectations are high. We went from, I think, one national TV game last year to 22. We ended up, I think, playing on three last year because the two that were added were, oops, this team back, this team couldn't do it or that team couldn't do it, and so they went to us. So how do we handle expectations? And I tried to simply put it to our guys that, hey, we have to understand and acknowledge that, the expectations are high, but our fans' expectations are our reality. We expect to compete for a championship. So any of the noise that we hear out there, you best believe that we're trying to attain that and more.
And from a roster standpoint, you don't really have
as far as Darren Fox this year. He was on a high level last year. Yeah. Now, you're looking for him to hit that next plateau. What is your thoughts about him playing?
I tell you what, he was absolutely freaking great this summer. Not only with his development, but he was basically here every single day. Not just working out, work on his game, but he was around all of our young guys, helping them elevate their game. He took Keegan under his wing on a daily basis and showed Keegan how to work, how to get better, as well as the other young guys when they got here too. So I'm excited about Foxy. He's just barely scratching the surface of who he can be as a player, which is scary. It should be scary for everybody else. But he's also showing the ability to lead and lead at a high level. When he talks, I told him this the other day, there have been some camps that the guys got together at, and at the end of the camp, I'm sitting there listening to them close the camp or end the day or whatever, and Foxy's always one of the guys that speaks up. And when he speaks, I'm 100% engaged now, because I'm holding on to every single word that he says because of his growth, his maturity in that department.
What do you make of what's happened in the West this summer and the talent and the depth you guys are going to have to go up against?
A lot of teams have gotten better. It's going to be hard. It's going to be harder than last year for sure. We want that. We expect it. And if we expect to be champions, we're going to have to step up, face the music, and get through it.
How do you feel about your positional versatility between the 2 and the 3, the 3 and the 4? Do you feel like you have a little bit more options now?
Again, I like the group that Monty and Wes assembled. I'm excited about seeing how we perform as a group when the lights come on. But on paper and what we've seen so far in the pickup games or scrimmages and our little get-togethers, I do like what we have.
Because the offense was obviously one of the best in basketball last year. I'm curious, how much do you change from last year to this year, if at all?
No, we feel like we need to tweak some things, and obviously when you get into a grueling playoff series versus, the 4 or 5 time NBA world champions in the Golden State Warriors, they make you adjust and they throw things at you defensively that kind of make you sit back and go, okay, people are going to watch this film. So we need to change this, adjust that, and see if we can come up with something that still fits our style of play while combating the issues that we faced against the Warriors and some of the other teams during the course of the regular season.
What does that look like for you? What kind of changes? I mean, obviously you don't have to go deep into detail, but what are some things that may look different?
We may add some things with our DHO game. Everybody knows we like to play. We have a DHO game that's pretty effective, especially between Domas and Kevin. And a lot of times it comes out of a deep corner. I don't know if you guys remember, we moved that to half court. We moved those guys to half court and had it going uphill so they couldn't sit on the top side and stop us from coming over the top of the handoffs from the deep corner. That's just one that was very obvious to everybody. There are others, too, that we're going to make. There are other areas where we're going to make some changes offensively so that, you know, if we're in a physical series, guys can't hold us and grab us and bump us and knock us off course to disjoint what we're trying to do offensively. We want to continue to be able to give guys space and the ability to have different options. If they take this away, boom, right now do that. If they take that away, boom, right now do this. And so we're continuing to try to tweak it to be better in those areas.
Mike, when you say you expect to compete for a championship, yep. Given your experience, what's the difference in terms of the day-to-day standard that a team has to have during a season when that is the expectation versus what your hopes were last year to just sort of break that playoff curve?
Yeah, again, like I said, we have to understand, you know, that the enemy of the great is the good. And most teams, and I say that because most teams are satisfied with being good. You know, because if everybody can live a good life at the salary they're at the rest of their life, not knowing that they think that they can't get fired and all that, most teams would, because most people in the U.S. have it pretty good. And so I don't want our guys to be complacent, because when you think that way, it's hard to be all in the process of trying to become great. To go from here to here, my opinion, is pretty easy. To go from here to here, that is freaking hard. To go from good to great is hard. And you know, it's hard because people don't want to deal with players, teams, organizations, groups. This applies to anybody. They don't want to deal with being open and honest with each other. It's hard to hear constructive criticism, you know, but you need to be open and honest with each other so we can all hold each other accountable. It's hard to come in every single day and go through the mental and physical stress of just trying to go a few milliliters or a few centimeters, however you want to call it, to go from good to great. You know, it's hard to be put in uncomfortable positions and embrace that, so come playoff time, you know, you face some adversity, you've gotten out of your comfort zone, now you're deep in the playoffs and you've got to make adjustments, and you run into some adversity and you've already experienced that and got through that as a team during the regular season, so now it may help you in a deep playoff run. You know, there are a lot of things that we will do on a daily basis, and we're going to call that winning the day. We want to win every single day that we're here, and part of that, doing those things, focusing on the details, focusing on our work ethic and our competitive spirit, believing in each other that we're going to succeed because we're playing the right way. So there are a lot of little things that I've already addressed to our team that we need to accomplish in order to go from good to great.
Mike, correct me if I'm wrong, does the start of this training camp feel, you've been here for a year plus, you're coming off a playoff run versus last year when you were new, your first year, still getting to know the guys, the disappointment of all those missed playoff seasons, how different does it feel year two for you than year one?
Well, obviously there's a little bit of comfort because we have a lot of guys back and we're starting to form a nucleus that, in my opinion, most good teams or organizations out there have when it comes to moving forward as a group or as a unit. And, you know, we're excited about the work that they put in and so that over the summer and the connectivity that they had over the summer. So having the nucleus, the group back, giving these guys a chance to grow and see if we can grow from within gives me and everybody else a little bit of a comfort zone because we've all been through a lot of stuff together. And so it's now just time to continue to build on that narrative as opposed to last year when you're coming in. We really didn't know much about anything. All we could do is hope, guess, assume, and pray. You know, and this year you have a little bit more to lean on based on the performance of last year and what we did over the summertime.
All right, thanks everyone.